The Holy Gospel is written in the 24th chapter of the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ as recorded by St. Luke, beginning at the 35th verse.
here. The Lord is here. He will surely do. I decree and I declare that from every form of disease, from every form of ailment, you are set free in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. By His stripes you are healed.
Amen.
Say, by His stripes you are healed.
Amen.
It is done.
Amen.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we appreciate you for the joy of salvation that we have through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose resurrection from the dead about 2,000 years ago was celebrated in the Christian calendar. And we decree, we pray at this moment that that power of resurrection will work wonders in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The power that raised Jesus from the dead will quicken your mortal body and deliver you and raise you from every form of problem and bondage in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you so much for the gift of life that you have given to each and every one of us, able to gather at this year's synod of our great houses. May your name be praised forever in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the houses of Emmanuel, one of the foremost dioceses in the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion, whose 70th anniversary of inauguration was marked very recently. Thank you, Lord, for all our diocesan officials and all synod delegates that are here gathered, our resource persons, and every arrangement put in place for the hosting of this synod. Be now exalted and glorified forever and ever in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our Father, our God, we cannot but appreciate you for our diocesan and Mama, your son, the most reverend Dr. Joseph Akinfenwa. Thank you, Lord, for your grace upon his life and our mother in Israel, Mama Comfort Akinfenwa. We express our profound gratitude to you for the inspiration of the Holy Spirit given to him to shoot the theme of this year's synod, Eternity in View. Be prepared. Help us to be heavenly minded, Lord, and live our lives with the consciousness of eternal life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we gather, Lord, speak to us.
Amen.
Speak to us in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And that, Lord, throughout this session of the synod, your name alone will be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for hearing us. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Let the people of God shout the God runs,
hallelujah.
The Lord is good. And all the time. Let's be seated, please. Your grace and my Father, I want to sincerely appreciate you for this rare opportunity and privilege given to me to preach at the opening session of this year's synod. I want to salute your dynamism and leadership style. You are not only charismatic, you are indefatigable, spirit-filled, generous, Baba Akinfenwa, and Mama Akinfenwa are just too generous. Happy Mubarak. Say Mubarak. Just too generous. The hospitality of Mama is second to none. I want to thank God for their lives. I know what I'm saying. Baba will not want me to say this. On the day of my enthronement, I have gotten the Pope I'm going to use. I was to use ready. But there was an hour to the time. Baba just came. And before you know it, I have to change my mind. And but today, I have two special popes. And one of the popes was one I used on the day of my enthronement.
They are just too beautiful and dignified. Whenever I put it on, I just give praise to God.
Your best, I'm so grateful, sir. A shape up, up. A shape up.
Baba is a child of God. He's a bishop of bishops, archbishop of archbishops, a great evangelist and a disciple.
Now when I say this, I know what I'm saying.
In Okino Shooters is where I came from. Many churches have become more evil. Now we're moving from one village to the other, trying to resuscitate and replant churches where necessary. And I got to a place known as Papu. Hello? Because Papu is so close by me. I thought let me just go there, there's a place that I can plant church. I go to the place, and there's an entrance church here now. Let me see, close here. I go there, and here, in my analysis. And on entering the ministry, I saw Baba Bishop. I said, wow, so Baba has been here again. Baba, I push out. I push out. The church is there, the big place is big field. About to be completed. The Lord will give you the grace. Maybe after completion, I will come. I'm prostrate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I commend you for your evangelical programs. Your right thoughts on Sunday tribune that you come there every Sunday. Very powerful. Other evangelical programs in the diocese are so great. The Jesus Festival is there, and many others. I'm a friend to the diocese on my Facebook, and I see Baba going from one village to the other in this diocese. The Lord will continue to strengthen you. You will not grow weary. He shall be well with you. Thank you for this opportunity given to me to be here to preach at this opening synod. I must appreciate our father. He's also my brother. I'm so proud. My wife is here. We are so proud to be one of your sons in the Epicot Ministry. We are so proud of you, sir. Thank you, darling. Baba, Olushola, the right reverend Dr. Jack Olushola is here from if he shall not eat thou sis. Daddy, you are welcome. My father is also here. Retired but not tired. The ex-wife bishop of Ogbomosho Diocese. Baba, the right reverend professor Oshuade. Daddy, you are welcome. On behalf of his lordship, I want to welcome everybody, but on behalf of his grace, Baba is another bishop. I want to welcome everybody to this diocese. The Chancellor, you are welcome. They've been led by the Chancellor, Honorable Justice M.H. Ogu Ubijo. Then the Registrar, Vice Priest, the Raji M.O. Then the Deputy Register, my M.O. M.N.O. Your Pastor, Vice Staff today, Udupon. You are welcome in Jesus' name. I also want to welcome all delegates to the synod. The Lord will bless you richly in the mighty name of Jesus. The theme of the synod is eternity in view, being prepared. And I'm starting to take the text from Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 to 14. And I read, brethren, I can not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth those things which are before. I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Eternity in Him, be prepared. Eternity is from the Greek word aeonos, meaning everlasting.
perpetual, forever, endless, ageless, limitless, timeless, ceaseless, without end, and so on and so forth. It is a quality of life that is conformed to the limitation of time. It describes the real life, the very essence of life, the very life of God Himself. And that is why this year's Synod Theme is very important. People of God, we live at a very precarious time, which Apostle Paul described as a perilous one, when men's hearts are failing them, and have therefore become lovers of themselves, rather than lovers of God. Lovers of money, blasphemers, slanders, traitors, etc. You see this in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 following. See what the love of money has turned our nation to. Look at the daily killings in the name of rituals and objective money. Look at the bandits in our society. Look at Boko Haram. Look at every form of evil that is being perpetrated every day. We live at a time that Paul also described as a period when people will no longer endure sound doctrine, but according to their own desire and because they have itching ears, they heed for themselves teachers, pastors, and prophets. They turn their ears from the truth. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3 to 5. And in our text, if we read down to Philippians chapter 3, verse 18 to 19, Paul says, "For many walk, of whom I have told you often, and now tell you, even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is their shame, who mind earthly things." We live at a time when people don't want to be corrected or rebuked, when they err or sin. As we are coming, I was just going through my Twitter. You had a very terrible incident that happened in the school at Lagos. And the young girl of 10 years old was saying, "What has happened? Is it this one alone that you have seen, and you see they are seized by iPhone now? Many more are coming that I'm going to post." A girl of 10 years old. May the Lord deliver this nation in the mighty name of Jesus. Many do not want to be corrected or rebuked when they err. All these and many more are recorded in 2 Matthew Gospel chapter 24. And they were the signs of the end time in which we find ourselves. The theme, Eternity in View, talks about the real reason, the real essence of knowing and accepting the salvation found only in our Lord Jesus Christ. In John 3:16, the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Why? God is eternal. We are created in His image and likeness. And this shows that man is also eternal. We are an eternal being. Genesis 1:27. Since we are created by eternal God, who gave us His eternal nature, that at the end of our temporal stay on earth, we will dwell with Him as He has promised, "I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may also be." Then we are not to live as though there are no life expectancy beyond the earthly grave. The world we live in is not the end of everything. But many behave as if everything ends here on earth. One of the guys that has gone for a ritual said he had
How many billion? Maybe 6 billion or 7 billion to spend within 6 years. He said the money is too much that he cannot finish it. That is the hard world in which we find ourselves. They think everything is on earth alone. But people of God, it is not like that. It is not like that. Eternity is a prepared place for a prepared people. A prepared place for a prepared people. The question is, are you prepared for eternity? Do you have eternity in view? There is a song that says, are you prepared for his glorious appearance? He's coming back. He's coming back. Are you prepared for his glorious appearance? He's coming back again. He's coming back again. Yes, Lord Jesus is coming back again. Glory, hallelujah. Praise his name and lift him up. Praise God. He's coming back again. Are you prepared? Our lives on earth is a temporary adventure, just a fraction of our overall life. James chapter 4 verse 14 says, for what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeared for a little time and then vanished away. Which means the end of earthly life is the beginning of an endless life in eternity. Daniel chapter 12 verse 2 explains eternity in two parts. One, everlasting life. And two, everlasting content or everlasting damnation. Jesus speaks of eternal life for the righteous and everlasting punishment or fire prepared for the devil and his cohorts. Matthew chapter 25 verse 41 and 46. Unfortunately, many people live as if there is no existence in eternity. They live without eternity in view. They are not prepared. And when not prepared for everlasting life with Christ, they definitely are prepared for an eternal doom. In the world today, like I've said, people have not only lost foresight of eternity, but are daily despising eternal things. The emphasis now is on ephemeral things. The materialistic variables of life that fades away. Paul, in verse 7 of the Bible passage, choosing as step for as not him, says, for what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. Paul here considered all he had ever accomplished in life as a loss when compared with the greatness of knowing Christ. That's a profound statement about values. It shows that our relationship in Christ is far more important than anything else in life, because it is through him that we have eternal life. Where do you place your value? On what do you place your value? It is difficult for people nowadays to mind spiritual things. Talk to them about anything spiritual, they just jettison it or make a laugh of it, laugh it off. It shouldn't be. Various passages in the scripture picture the Christian life as a race, and every race has a clearly defined finishing line, which is the ultimate goal, that is to make heaven. Runners don't win the race without adequate preparation. They also have to be well focused. Their eyes have to be straight ahead without looking backward, so that they won't miss their goal. That is why in verse 3 of the same Philippians, in verse 13 of the same Philippians chapter 3, Paul says, brethren, I do not regard myself
laid hold of it yet, for one thing I do, forgetting that which lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on towards the goal to win the prize for which God called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. People of God, let me remind you that the greater part of our life, the greater part of our life will be spent in eternity. Even if you are hold as Methuselah, one day you will come home. And there you spend several years. Even Methuselah did not live up to 1,000 years. Hallelujah. 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 So what does that mean? It means wisdom demands that we be conscious. We pay attention to our eternal destination. We should be concerned with eternity. To live with eternity in view is living in the present with the end in mind. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 19 says, if in this life only we have hope in Christ, then we are all men most miserable. We must then live as strangers and pilgrims in the world, and so be like the wise virgins who are in readiness for the coming of the bridegroom. We must not love the world, neither the things that are in the world. The Bible says, if anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the heart and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but of this world. 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 to 17. And Jesus says, watch, because you do not know on what day your Lord will come. Matthew 24, verse 42. The question is a day. How prepared are you for eternity? Can you sleep while the winds blow? Can you sleep while the wind blows? How prepared are you? There was a story about a farmer who regularly advertised for hired hands in his farm. But because of the difficult terrain of his farm, most qualified people were reluctant to work there. They dreaded the awful storms that rained across the area, wreaking havoc on the building and crops. As the farmer interviewed applicants for the job, he received a steady stream of refusal. People would not want to go because of the problem in the farm. However, there was this young man, a young boy, very short and thin, that came to the farmer to be employed. And the farmer asked him, are you a good farmhand? What is your qualification? The boy replied, well, I have none, but I can sleep when the wind blows. I can sleep when the wind blows. Puzzled by this answer, the farmer was reluctant to hire him. But because he was in desperate need for a helping hand, he gave him the employment. The little man worked very well in the farm, busy from dawn to dusk, diligently doing his given task. Then one night, the wind blew loudly in from the offshore. The owner of the farm jumped from his bed, ran to the little boy's quarters, and woke him up. I said, boy, storm is coming, get up. And the little boy turned on his back and said, sir, I have told you I can sleep when the wind blows. The man was furious and was very annoyed. And he ran to the farm. On getting to the farm, he looked around. He discovered that everything was in order. The man rolled over in bed. He described that everything was in order. The barn, the chicken, the hen were in their pen, the cow, everything. The little boy has taken care of them all. And remember what the little boy said, I can sleep when the wind blows. I can sleep. So to the man's amazement, he discovered that all the haystacks had been covered with tarpaulin. The cows were in their barn, the chicken were in their fence, and the doors were locked. The shutters were tightly secured. Everything was tied down. Nothing could blow away. Then he understood what the little boy meant when he said, I can sleep when the wind blows. Can you sleep when the wind blows? How prepared are you for eternity? What constitutes readiness and preparedness for eternity? In your readiness for eternity, you don't live to please yourself. You don't live to please the devil. You live to please your maker. You have to be born of God. Before you can please your maker, you must be born of God. The Bible says, who is he that overcometh the world? He that believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. You must please your maker. Live to please your maker. Be genuinely born again. Surrender all to him. That is the starting point. Then two, live as an ambassador of the kingdom. Live as an ambassador of Christ's kingdom. Let his brand mark be formed on your head. Let people know that really you are a child of God. Then lay up your treasures before him. As found in Matthew chapter 6, verse 19, verse 20 to 21, that reads, lay not up yourself for yourself treasures on earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through. Three, love your neighbor. Love your neighbor. As yourself, let's love one another. Love for others must begin in the church. If we are to love all people, if we are to love our neighbor, then the love must begin in the church. And this love is the agape, not eros, not phileo. The agape, love without any condition. God's kind of love. Then live to serve others in love. Live to share God's love and then share God's love among people. Your relationship with God as well as your relationship with people affect your eternity with God. If you say you love God and you hate your brother, then you are a liar. That's what the Bible says. Stop playing with malice and bitterness. Stop taking offenses. Don't be easily offended. Many of us are easily offended. Let love be genuine. Then we'll be candidate for eternity. Then the fourth point I'm placing in your hand is look forward to Christ's coming. Philippians chapter 3, verse 20-21 says, for our conversation is in heaven, from whence also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Titus chapter 2, verse 11-13 says, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
You must look towards the second coming of Christ. The parousia is imminent. Christ is coming back. Don't let us live as if Christ is not coming back again. He's coming back, and he will surely fall. He just bowed, literally bowed. He just bowed, literally bowed. My gentle love, bowed me the leo. He must so long.
Oh, open our hearts. Let us thank God for the gift of life. Let us thank God for the greatest gift of mankind, of the Son Jesus Christ. Let us thank God for his death and his resurrection, that we have him in the message. If Christ has not resurrected, then of all people were the most miserable. We thank God, our hope is not only in this world. We have an eternity waiting for us, especially for those who have been here. Let us thank God. Let us thank God for the relative peace in the city of Ibadan, in our Lord's state, that we can gather here today. Let us thank God for the life of our leaders in this diocese, Baba Mama Kipewa. Let us thank God for the preparation put together by this parish church and Mary's Uriyore and Yadi Kemri. Thank God for the clergy and the laity of Yadi Kemri, for the enablement, for the resources put together to host this year's synod, the third session of the church, the third synod of the diocese. Let us thank God because he has something for us in this nation and is going to execute it. That the wickedness of the wicked will be terminated. That every tongue of Israel will be uprooted from the land. Let us thank God. Let us thank God for his church, because you know that we are sure that the gate of hell will never be closed over his church. Let us thank God because you know his presence is already with us and see us through this synod this year. Lord, in your mercy, let us pray for the church and for the world. And let us thank God for his goodness. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, you have promised through your Son Jesus Christ to hear us when we pray in faith. Strengthen Henry, our primate, Shepherd, our bishop, and our latter-day, Shepherd, our bishop, and our latter-day, our bishop. Lord, the church in the service of Christ, that those who confess to you may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, bless and guide our rulers. Give wisdom to all in authority, especially warrior president, Oshiba, the vice president, and all the advisors at federal level. She gave the governor in the state and those who are working with them in the state and other governors. The referees are recognition in the ways of justice and of peace, that people may honor one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy, God of grace, give us grace, our families and our friends, and to all our neighbors, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, comfort to Lord and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, those on admission to hospitals, and those in their different homes. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear us as we remember those who died in the faith of Christ. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Individually, let us ask God that in this synod this year, this is my heart's desire. This is what I want. Meet me at the point of my needs. Thank you for the word you have spoken and deposited in my heart. Cause this one to germinate so that daily I will be prepared to meet you in your eternity. Pray that no matter what goes on in this nation, I will not be consumed about by the atrocity in the land. I will not have part in the sorrow, the lamentation in the land. Gods are going to be established in your righteousness, O Lord. Terror and oppression will be far from me and my family. Just remember pray for Papa tomorrow as he delivers the charge, send your son. Empower him with your spirit. Lord, in your mercy, we just need the fellowship of all your saints. We commend ourselves and all Christian people to your living Lord. Merciful Father, sister, this prayer for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Please stand from page 12 of the pamphlet. We are in body of Christ. In one spirit, we are all baptized into one body. And of them was Lord that makes for peace and build all our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another the sign of peace. of goodness we have this bread to offer, which the earth has given, and human hands have made, to become for us bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness you have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of humanity, it should become our spiritual food.
Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, who are in through your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and as you follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, this gift of bread and wine may be to us God has brought with the same night that he was betrayed to pray. Give it to them, saying, take this. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way as the Son, Jesus took the cup and gave it to them. And drink this cup of me. This is my blood that the new covenant will be shed for the love of many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this. As often as you drink this, in remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you. And his blood is shed for you. Eat and drink, remember that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your heart. Faith and thanksgiving. The body of Christ keeps you in eternal life. The blood of Christ keeps you in eternal life.
we have the evolution, the first and the last. So we understand.
To the first day
of the third session of our 23rd Synod. Like to welcome all of us in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, in the power of the President of Synod, the Most Reverend Dr. Diakon Fenwa, our assistant, and also the President of the Human Organizations, Mamasi Diakon Fenwa. You are welcome in Jesus' name. It's a prayer that our day is here shall be peaceful and enjoyable in the name of Jesus Christ. On their behalf, I'd like to welcome all our fathers in God present at this service. I'd like to start with our guest preacher, the Right Reverend Fabulujan, Bishop of Okeosun Diocese. Thank you very much for coming, and thank God for the message. Welcome to bless your episcopacy in the name of Jesus Christ. As you came there, Savior, you return to begin, Savior, in the name of Jesus. The same way, I'd like to recognize and welcome Most Reverend M.O. Akinyemi, retired Archbishop of Kwara and retired Bishop of the Roman Diocese. Baba, you are welcome, sir. So welcome and recognize one of our fathers, now a distinguished parishioner in St. Mary's, the Right Reverend Professor M.A. Oshunade, doing multi. Abba, you are welcome in Jesus' name. So I'd like to welcome the Right Reverend J.F. Olushola, Bishop of Jesha Northeast Diocese. Welcome, sir. Right Reverend Adiroga, Lord Bishop of Jeba Diocese, you are welcome. And so here we are, Savior, you don't save it in the name of Jesus Christ. Also, on behalf of Papa and Mama, I'd like to welcome and appreciate our Honorable Chancellor, Honorable Justice H.M. Ogunbiju. You are welcome. So came here, saving and become saving in Jesus' name. The registrar is our host, but at the same time, we must also recognize him. Barrister General at the AMO. Thank you for coming. Deputy Registrar and Legal Secretary, Barrister Sunday Olukwanu, you are welcome. Medical Advisor, Pharmacist Sunday Bambola, you are welcome. Thank you very much for coming. It's a prayer that you are present today, you all. We will be able to attend all the sessions in good health in the name of Jesus Christ. On behalf of all of us, I'd like to congratulate our Papa Amama, the Most Reverend Dr. Amama Siwa Tufenwa, also for this third session of our 23rd Synod. Papa Amama, congratulations, sir. So I pray that God will strengthen you, and as your day, so shall you strengthen me in the name of Jesus Christ. Also, let me, on behalf of every one of us present here, clergy and laity, appreciate the host church and adjutant, starting with the vicar and his wife, whatever Mrs. Fanny, the church wardens, the PCC, the local organizing committee, the choir, the organist, choir master, for your well done. God bless you today in the name of Jesus Christ. The gift of stewards and all our youths who assisted us. Also, thank you very much. God will reward you richly in the name of Jesus Christ. So I want to, So I want to appreciate all our bishops who are present at this service. Thank you very much for coming. As you came safely, you come safely in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you richly. Instead of the usual roll call by calling our names one after the other, because it normally takes probably another 1 hour or more, we have shifted to this method of asking you. Delegates only now, not those who are attending the service as members of St. Mary's, and not clergyers. So ushers, please come to give to senior delegates. Ushers, ushers. Seminary is ushers. Ever looking. Praise the Lord. Only synod delegates and the clergy, that is Bishop Dominic, members of the assistant board, assistant officials, synod delegates. But if they're not your type, they may not give you. So please, just raise your hand if you're a synod delegate. Then clergy. They will feel it and will collect it back immediately. For tomorrow, the morning service will start at 7:30 and goes about we start the service at 7:30 a.m. and it goes with the Bible study. So please let's make effort to be here on time. The Bible study will replace the sermon. So please take notes. In your synod Bibles, we have the Bible study line there. So you are free to go through. For the group work in the afternoon tomorrow and also for Yule of Saturday, we have the following. So please listen carefully to your name. Communique Committee, Venerable Kony Babalola is chairman. Doctors, members, Dr. Shoti Lohi, Comrade Oluabiala, Venerable Balaji, Professor Mrs. Oshobishman, Professor Mrs. Lavinju, Mr. Okoro Okuntoyu, and Reverend Aristide Okun Olarimoye. Group 2, we discuss or review the reports on theology colleges, about the Assistant School of Theology, and United Comprehensive College, and Bishop Akinyele Grammar School. Those in the group 2 are clergy and laity from the Cathedral, Bodija, and Jogodo Ajikemis. Chairman will be the Provost Reverend Dr. Labrador, and Vice Chairman will be the Bobawe. Group 3, we discuss DIB reports, IBSS bookshop reports, and the task force report on the Dawson Events and Retreat Center. Those in the group are Maliti Ajikunri, clergy and laity, Naledi Ajikunri, clergy and laity, Okebola Ajikunri, clergy and laity, and then Convention Churches, clergy and laity. Chairman will be Venerable Alessandra, and Vice Chairman, Venerable Sunday Zike. Group 4, we discuss or review and submit their report or recommendations on reports from Dawson Women Organization, DYD, DMS, and all the other departments as they are contained in that program booklet. There are many of them. So please, those in that group will work hard on that. Number 2, they are not voluminous, but you can still look at each of them on their own merit. Chairman of the Venerable Fale and assisted by Vice Chairman Venerable Jacob Obisanya. Group 5, the Assistant Hospital and all the mission field reports. Those in that group are, sorry, group 4, Oluyole Ekotedo,
Ashiaji Greece. Oleole, Ekotelo, Ashiaji Greece, Clarky and Nate. Group 5. Olubadan, Agobaji Greece, and Congregation of Churches. The man of the mission group, so please take note. Clarky and Nate. The chairman, Venerable Kwame Paeda, Vice Chairman, Venerable Agaran, will discuss the assistant hospital admission field reports and look at them, then submit your recommendations. For the most voluminous of all the reports, cathedral and itinerary reports, Chairman of CP, Mr. Banjo Shukunle, Father Member Close Oshonubi, Mr. Gordon Omo Tyler, Architect of Kuma Faye, Mr. Derek Omo, Mrs. Idowo Gwinika, Seme Odunsi, Mr. Ayo Jelabi, Evangelist Wally Anjori, and Mr. Rotimi Omondem. So please take note, I will repeat this tomorrow morning also so that we know where we are to go. By the time we are going, we will tell you where to stay. Now we are going for this exercise. Please submit, ushers can collect the papers back. I believe I might have finished. Thank you very much.
make you steadfast.
Amen.
Make you perfect.
Amen.
Make you joyous.
Amen.
Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, your God, Lord, and remain with you this night and always. Friends of the church, our youth, the Shebuko, we will have more to say tomorrow.